Hi there, let's continue with this formatting of the gallery that we just stopped in the last video where we learned about containers. We learned and practiced putting everything inside a container that's occupying the full width and height of the screen. Now we are going to do this alignment of the labels inside the gallery with the labels in the header and make them always aligned. It doesn't matter the size of the screen that the app is playing. Okay, so we are going to act inside each label, the gallery. We are going to put formulas in the X and in the width properties of each label. We have the gallery right here. We didn't rename yet, so let's rename. Let's call Gall Items Example. And we also have the labels inside it that we didn't rename. Let's rename at least the labels that we are seeing here in the app. This one will be item name, so LBL item name. This one, it's the item size, so LBL item size. This one is the model, so LBL item model. And the last one is the class, LBL item class. It's very important to rename because then when we look here in the left, in the tree view, we see the things with their names and we understand what they are easier. Okay, now we want, for example, this label to be always in the same position vertically as this label here in the top. What we are going to do is we're going to make the X, the position, the X horizontally, the horizontal position of this label to be the same as this one. So let's get the name of the label in the top. That's called LBL name title. I will copy, Ctrl C. Here I'm going to click the label inside the gallery and I'm going to go to the X in the position property. So clicking the X here in the top, I'm seeing that there's a number, but let's put to have the same X as the label in the header. So name of the label in the header dot X. Let's do this to all the other labels. And then we are going to see what's going to happen. We see that this first one is already aligned. Let's see now for this one, the position, the size label. I'm going to get the name of the label. That's the header for the size, Ctrl C. Here in the X, let's put it to have the same X as that label. So name of the label dot X. We see that it's already aligned with that label. It shows this error because when we just pasted the name here and we didn't put dot X, it was not bringing a number and Power Apps just complained because that wasn't a valid number, just put in the name. But once we put .x, it worked. So that error is just an error message that appeared, but we haven't finished the formula yet. So it thought we had finished and showed as an error, but it wasn't because we were going to put .x. Okay, let's do for the model. I'm going to select and copy the name of the label in the header and in the X property of this label, I'm going to paste and put .x. See the error message appearing again, but it's because we didn't have the .x at that point. Why didn't it apply? Okay, I clicked in the wrong thing, maybe. Model, item, model, title, .x. Oh, I put in the width. I put in the wrong place. Let me remove from the width. Just set 200, let's say, and then put in the dot X. So in the X property and paste here. Okay, now it's aligned. And for this last one, so let's get the name of this label, LBL item class title. And here in the X property of this label inside the gallery, just paste and dot X. Now the labels are always aligned vertically. They have the same position in the X as the labels in the top. If I play the app, I can see that they are aligned, and now if I resize the screen, once the labels in the top we resize because they have flexible width, as we put in previous classes, the others will align vertically because they are referring to the X positions of these labels. One last thing that we need to do here is to make them align vertically, so they are all in the same height. So let's select all of them, right click, align to the top. We can also force them to have the same height. They have already 49, but I see it's too big, right? We can click here in the auto height, so the height will adapt automatically. If the text is bigger, then it will grow vertically, this label, as we can see here in the ear protection earmuffs. One last adjustment we can do, not one last one, another adjustment, is that we can make this label have the same width as this label in the top. So we give extra space for this one, for example, because right now the width is this, and we would have this empty space here that we could use to show text to. And if the width of the top one decreases, this one right now is fixed and it won't decrease. So let's also link the same width. Let's make the width of the label inside the gallery have the width of the label in the header. So I'm going to click again in the header label, copy the name, and now in the width property of the label inside the gallery, let's change to name of the label in the top, dot width. And we can see that its width is the same now as the width from the label in the header. Let's do for the other labels inside the gallery. So I'm copying the name of this one in the top, going to the one inside the gallery, the width, Ctrl V, dot width. So now it has the same width as the label in the top. Next one, model, Ctrl C, width, Ctrl V, dot width. I'm doing quicker because now you already understood what's the process, so we just need to do there. Now for the class, copy the name and put in the width property of this label here, dot width. Okay. Now they all of them have the same width as the one in the top. Here we see that this label is too wide. We don't need that label to be so wide as it is because the image has always this size. We could make it be bigger, but I don't think it's worth it. Let's imagine we want it to have always a fixed size of 60 by 60. I just changed here in the right the width and the height. Okay, so we don't want this label to be so wide. Let's deactivate the flexible width for this label. Since it's inside the container, we have this property, we can disable and then force it to be, let's say, 70. So it will always take this size, it won't enlarge, it won't get widened as the screen gets, because we always have this size for this column, and the others will keep adjusting because the flexible width is active for them. Now it looks very good. Imagine that the name, we wanted this one to be always bigger than the others. Let's remember that we set the minimum width for all of them as 50. We could put this one, for example, to be 150, so it won't get smaller than this, because the name, usually, it's a bigger string, it's a bigger text. Now, the minimum size will be 150, as I just set in the minimum width. Let's play and decrease the size of everything. And we can see that the others have a smaller size than the name header, because we put a minimum width that's bigger than the others. Okay, very good. Now our gallery is already adapting Almost very well. There is one last thing that we want to do. That's when the screen is too narrow, we want the texts to decrease the font size. Okay? In order to do this, we need to understand a little bit better about one property. That's the size of the screen that's showing here. And we have something that helps us. That's called size breakpoints. Let me see how big is this video. Okay, this video is getting too big. I'm going to teach this in the next video. Let's just do one final adjustment here. That is, we can now remove the background colors for the labels here in the header, for example, so it looks nicer, and also remove the background color of the gallery. If we want, and also put the headers in bold letters. So let's do that. I'm going to select all these labels, change the font weight to bold, and remove the background color. So I just put white, actually. Yes. No, not act. Maybe it's better to put transparent, so it takes the same color as the background element. So here I'm going to put transparent. I don't know why it's not getting the color. If I go to the fill property, it should be color.transparent then. I don't know why it didn't work in there. Should work, but let me type here. So I just went to the fill properties of the labels and put color dot transparent. That it would happen here when I clicked here in this fill icon. I don't know why, but okay, it worked like this. Okay, now it's a little better already. We have a header and we have the gallery here. We can also decrease a little the height of each line of the gallery. So if I select the gallery, we have the template size property. Since the gallery is inside a container, I cannot drag here. It doesn't work. It's locked. I need to select the gallery, go to the template size, and change here. Let's say it's 80. Okay, now it looks a little better. Let me just put the image a little up. And we have this separator that's a rectangle. Let me decrease its height. Let's put 4. Okay. Okay, so now it looks better. And last thing before we finish this class, let's put this icon that's floating here in the middle of the gallery to be in the very end. But how can we do that if the end will change according to the width of the app? We need to put some formula here also. So I'm going to click in this icon. If I move it to the end, it won't work nice because if the screen is bigger, then it won't be in the end. So what we can do is we can refer this based on the width of the gallery. So let's say the position, it will be the very end of the gallery, so that means the X position of this control, the icon, will be parent.width, because we want it to be in the very end of the gallery, parent.width, and the parent in this case is the gallery that this icon is inside. So it went to the very end of the gallery, but after the gallery. Now we need to just move it back to the left a little. And this amount is its own width, the own width of the icon. So in this case is minus self.width. In this case, it will go to the very end minus its own width. That it means it will be attached to the right of the gallery. And if the gallery changed the size, it will also change the position based on the width of the gallery. See, now it's always here in the right. So if I move, that icon will always go together. Okay, now we're ready to make the changes in the text font size based on in the screen width. See you in the next video. I will leave the link right now so you can click to the next video and watch together with me. See you there.